Sydney's nightlife could soon be revived, with the Premier flagging the divisive lockout laws could be relaxed in the city centre. But no such hopes for King's Cross. It will be excluded from any changes.
When it comes to Sydney's controversial lockout laws, the Premier, it seems, has finally heard the drums beating. This was Cabramatta's annual Moon Festival, friendlier territory for Gladys Berejiklian than among the nightlife advocates of King's Cross and the CBD. For them, though, a peace offering, with suggestions the tough laws might be relaxed or even repealed in the city and surrounding areas.
I do think we need to step it up in terms of our nightlife, and this is a good time to look at that, given it's been 5 years since the lockout laws came into place.
No change for King's Cross, though, where teenagers Thomas Kelly and Daniel Christie were killed in one-punch attacks. The laws forced venues to refuse entry to patrons after 1:30 a.m, with last drinks served at 3.
We've lost over 170 venues, and we've really taken a hit to Sydney's image here and around the world. So yes, it's about time.
But this is hardly a done deal. The government still has to wait for the recommendations of a parliamentary committee due in the next few weeks, and any decision to water down the laws would have to go to Cabinet. And then there are the inevitable critics.
Among them, police.
The measures have been shown to work. Public safety has increased. A committee has heard evidence. Let's see the committee's report.
And St Vincent's Hospital, fearful of again seeing endless alcohol-related injuries.
I can tell you now that if you increase the trading hours, you will see a return to those bad old days. It's the doctors and nurses at St Vincent's who will be left to pick up the pieces.
Eddie Meyer, Nine News.
Hi, YouTubers. I'm Davina Smith. Well, click here to keep watching great Nine videos and subscribe to our channel here for lots more news, analysis and exclusive content. For breaking news, see you at ninenews.com.au.